So welcome back children to my tutorial again. So what we have learnt in the previous episodes, that is the special property of carbon, that is the catenation, self-linking and tetravalency, and about the isomerism. Now today we will discuss about the classification of the organic compounds. So let's start. So children, let's go about the classification of the organic compounds. So as I have told already before in the part 1, that in your organic compounds, the main elements are the carbon and the hydrogen, and others are present. The main are the carbon and hydrogen. So the compounds where only carbon and hydrogen is present, they are called the hydrocarbons. Hydro means hydrogen, carbon means carbon. So in any compound, if you are seeing that there is the presence of the carbon and hydrogen, they are known as the hydrocarbons. So all the hydrocarbons can be divided into two types. One is the open chain, another one is the closed chain. Open chain means, you can see already I have told in that previous video, that is the like this open chain means it is open in both the ends, or upper side or the lower side. That is the open chain. It is called open chain. Like this, it is open. Now this is the second one is the closed chain. Means what? The open chain compounds can be called the aliphatic compound, and the closed chain compounds can call the cyclic compounds. Here I have given and I will tell you. So again, come to the open chain compounds. Open chain compounds can be divided into again two types. One is the saturated, another one is the unsaturated. So which compounds are called the saturated compounds? That the compounds which are having the single bond. As already I have told about in the previous video, that carbon can make the compounds in single bond, double bond or triple bond. So where the single bond is present, totally that compounds are called the saturated compounds, and where the double or triple bond is present, that compounds are called the unsaturated compounds. Again, saturated compounds are called the coming under the alkanes, A-N-E. That is the very very important part. These are the A-N-E, alkanes, or alkanes are also called the paraffins. And where the double and triple bond is present, these compounds can be divided into two parts. That is the alkenes, that is the very very important, and Y-N-E, alkynes. And alkenes are also called the olefins, and alkynes are also called the acetylenes. So here we will take one example. See here, here is the one carbon atom. You can take one also, or you can take two also. So here you count the bonds, that is the lines are the bonds. As I told that each carbon atom is having the tetravalency property, so you have to keep in your mind that whenever you are making the compounds, you must count these bonds, count these lines, that how many are there. You have always counted 4. So if 4 is over, means that bond is over, that valence electrons are over. Now see, here it is the 1, 2, 3, 4. Again in this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can arrange the hydrogen atoms accordingly. This 4, H, 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 H. You can count, that is that one. So here all are the single bond. So that is the call, it is called the alkanes. Means from this, what you understand children? That whenever single bond is present, that the compounds are named as A-N-E, at the suffix, that A-N-E must be there, and these are called the saturated compounds. Now see about the alkenes. As I told that they are the unsaturated compounds, so there must be double or triple bond, at least one, maybe more than, but at least one double bond or triple bond is present in that compound. So in your course, only one double or one triple bond is there. Now let's see. Suppose in between two carbon atoms, there is the double bond. Now you count the lines, that how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. So here there are the 3 hydrogen atoms, but here that is the 2 only, because here is the double bond. And for this carbon atom also, you can see this is the double bond, and another 2 bonds are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, these are called your alkenes, E-N-E, double means E-N-E. And these are also called the olefins. Now, come to the alkynes. Like the alkenes, here also, at least one triple bond must be there. More than one also may be there, but in your course, only one. So, at least one triple bond is present if any compound. So, they are known as the alkynes. Now, count the bond student. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, here only one H is present. Again, for this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's why these are coming under the group alkynes. Y-N-E. Suffix is Y-N-E. So, for this single bond, suffix is A-N-E. For the double bond, suffix is E-N-E. For the triple bond, suffix is Y-N-E. So, these are the open chain or aliphatics. Now, come to the closed chain or cyclic. These are divided into alicyclic and aromatic. So, what is this student you see here? So, second part is the closed chain or cyclic compounds. So, it is divided into alicyclic and aromatic. So, in your course, not more explanation is there. Only that open chain carbon atoms you have to read. So, at least you read about the what are the closed chains. Means sometimes, as I told, according to the catenation property, carbon can make the ring chains also. So, this is your ring chain, means cyclic compounds are there. It is a special structure of benzene, which is coming under the aromatic compound. So, more about the aromatic and alicyclic, you will read in your higher classes. So, again, only you just see here how to count the bonds. Suppose this C3 carbon atoms are arranged in like this, like a ring. So, here you see, here the carbon atom, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. For this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4. For this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, this is one type of compound. Another one type of compound, as I told, here double bond is there. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon atoms can be arranged in a ring. And here, between, see here, alternatively, in between these two carbon atoms, double bond. Again, in this carbon atom, single bond. Again, in this, double bond. So, alternatively, double and single bonds are there. And accordingly, you have to count the bonds. Now, for these carbon atoms, you see, that is the 1, 2, 3, 4. For this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4. For this also, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, for here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, it is one the special type of carbon. This is called the benzene. This is called benzene. E-N-E. As double bond is present, this is called benzene. And as I told that, differentiate between your organic and inorganic, it is an organic solvent. And this is called your, that is the cyclopropane. Cyclopropane, A-N-E. So, as A-N-E present, so here it is the single bond. So, it is called cyclo, means it is in the cyclic order. So, children, now see the next part of that one, very, very important part, saying that it is the starting of the organic chemistry. That functional groups, as I told that, carbon can link with each other with carbon atoms, and other than carbon atom also, it can be linked with others, maybe hydrogen or anything. That time I told, what are these anything? That are the functional group. So, what are these functional groups? Functional groups are the chemically reactive atoms. These are the chemically reactive atoms. Or a group of atoms, or a group of atom, maybe single atom, or maybe a group of atoms. What happened then? Where they are present? They are present in the compound or in the molecule, that is the organic, in the molecule of the organic compound, or you can say that in the organic compound. Organic compound, they are present in the organic compound, and According to that only, whatever the functional groups are present, according to that, that organic compounds exhibits the property. Means what I am telling? That these functional groups are carrying the properties of the organic compounds. Whatever your functional groups, according to that, the organic compounds are having the properties. Means what you have to write? Which is responsible? Responsible for the properties of the characteristics of the characteristics of the chemical properties. So how to write this definition, children? What you have to write, I have written here point wise. You have to make a sentence or make a paragraph as it is the definition. So how to write the definition then? Functional groups are the chemically reactive atom or the group of atom which is present in the molecules of the organic compound and responsible for its characteristics, chemical properties. This is the definition of your functional groups. I have written in a flowchart wise, you have to make a paragraph by adding some prepositions or like this. So if you, it is the main points of your definition, you have to mention that what are these and where is it present and what is the function of these functional groups. So children, now read about the different types of the functional groups. You have to remember right now. After that, what are these, how they are using, I will show you. So first you remember that wherever it will come the halo. Halo means it is coming from the halogens, from the periodic table, that is the chlorine, bromine, iodine, etc. Like this, your hydroxyl, you have to remember that what is coming, hydroxyl. Hydroxyl means the structure is, it is the single bond and OH. You have to remember, this is the important things. Here the structure is single bond Cl, single bond Br, single bond I, etc. So hydroxyl means there must be present that single bond OH and these groups are called the alcohols. Like this, here this is the aldehyde. Aldehyde, and the structure you have to remember, that is the C double bond OH. This is your structure, you have to remember. And here it is the suffix is Al. And here suffix is Ol. And another one is the ketone. Ketone means your structure is C double bond O. Here one, and it is the suffix is One. And here your carboxyl. Carboxyl, and your structure is C double bond O, OH, and the suffix is oic acid. So what are these? I will explain you later, but before that you have to remember, these are the very important. First you practice and remember, after that I will tell its use. So children, you have to remember the structures, that how is it, as I have done everywhere, that about the according to their bonds. So I will tell you in the next part that how you will use these bonds. So you practice all these things properly. So children, this is all about today's topic. So hope you understand this. But if you like this video, you understand these topics, please like my video and please give one comment so that I can also came to know that it is effective or not. So please children, again we will meet in the next video, and for that, bye bye. But before that I want to remind you, please subscribe, share, like and watch the full video and all the parts. Thank you children.